Welcome to Children's Time.
Thank you, Jade. Great job. Well, kids, today we have an interview with Brother IDK, but that will be a little later on because we want to start off with our science experiments. On that note, I want to thank Maven, Essence, Michael Salim, Salome, Justin Caden, Anaya, and Tex for sharing their experiments with us today. And I hope the following announcement will encourage other children to get involved. Science is connected with knowledge or knowing things. And a fear or respect of God is the beginning of knowledge. That's found in Proverbs 1:7. So we are encouraging children to participate in science because all true science comes from God and leads to God. In addition, God may choose to heal the world of diseases or other problems through the scientific discoveries that our children will engage in someday. I would like to encourage you to explore the lives of Patricia Bath, Alice Ball, Charles Drew, and Percy Julian. Do that with your child. These and other scientists have helped to make the world a better place, like Jesus did. Up next, our science experiments.
Hi kids, today I'm gonna be showing you a milk experiment. So let's get started. First, we're gonna need some food colorings with some milk. Now, we're gonna put in some of the food colorings. And with this hack, you're gonna need a lot. Whoa! All right, kids, now let's take our Q-tip with the dish soap and let's see what happens. Whoa!
Hi guys, what you're seeing is an acid reaction. Today, I made this lava lamp with water, oil, citric acid, and food coloring, and baking soda. Your favorite, you can even make cookies with it. So, just tune into my video on Oaktown. Bye! Now that was energy.
Hi, my name is Essence, and I am going to be focusing my project on today on Newton's first law. My definition of the first law is something continues in a state of rest or motion in a straight line unless that state is changed by a force. Now let's see what happens when I push the plate from under the egg. Will it fall and crack or will it survive? Let's see. In 3, 2, 1. And it looked like the egg survived. And it survived because of inertia and because it went straight down when I pushed the plate under it. That's all for today. Bye!
It's slow motion?
No, this is a regular video.
Can I see?
I know, man. See? Do the big one. Whoa!
Wow!
Yeah, man. That was a good one. Good job, man. High five.
Today, my experiment is jumping power. You see, it's already jumping, but you have to add in the water, then the kernels, and then the baking soda and white vinegar. The gas caused the kernels to dance. Bye, kids.
Hello, Town Scientist. My name is Sloan. This is my brother, my little Slim. And we're doing the Learn Battery Light Experiment. We have 2,000 mAh copper and zinc. We have wires all connected to an LED battery. Well, guys, it's a little light. In your lamp itself, God will still give it the power to shine. What do you think, Bible?
I don't know.
Bye, kids!
Hi, Brother IDK. Today for our lesson, I thought you and I can watch a video together to see how Jesus got the victory for us. And if you have any questions, Brother IDK, just tell me to stop and we'll talk about it. This video is called Jesus Christ, and it's an animation by Micah Raphael. I don't know how everybody else feels about it,
But I like animation. Yeah. All right. Well, here we go.
Jesus Christ, he's the greatest hero posterized. Satan and defeat is sin and death.
It's Christ that I believe
in. What's wrong? I don't know. I don't know what posterized means. I know about pasteurized, being a scientist and all that. That's like purifying milk. But I don't know about posterized.
Posterized means making a great sports play that confuses or embarrasses your opponent so much that they would look very silly if someone took a picture of them and put it on a poster.
I don't know if you have examples of that, but I need an example.
Sure.
Oh, I see. But how did Jesus posterize Satan?
Well, when Satan had Jesus beaten, nailed to the cross, speared in the side, and had his tomb sealed, Jesus posterized Satan by rising again on the third day with all power.
I don't know if there's any scripture that makes that point.
Oh, yeah. Actually, there is. That speaks of that. It's Colossians 2 and verse 15. While talking about what Jesus' death and resurrection means, it says this about Jesus. He disarmed the rulers and authorities, talking about even Satan, and made a public example of them, triumphing over them in it. What's wrong?
I don't know how I missed that, because I see it now. It says Jesus made a public example of them, including Satan.
Posterized.
That does sound like Satan got posterized.
He died on the cross, but he rose again. Jesus Christ.
Yeah. Okay, let's watch some more.
He's the greatest hero posterized. Satan and defeat is sin and death.
It's Christ that I believe in.
Stop.
What's wrong?
I don't know. I don't know what Abby's means.
Abby's?
Yeah. A-B-Y-S-S.
Oh, that's abyss.
Yeah. What was that?
Well, when Jesus didn't give in to sin, but resisted it and was crucified, Jesus got victory over Satan, sin, and death.
I get that part. They were cheating and robbing people of life, and that's why Micah in the animation has that scene about the bank. And Jesus' pure life and victorious death gave them power over them. But what's this abyss?
The abyss is a Greek word that's used in the Bible that represents the time and place when Jesus will get rid of Satan, sin, and death forever.
I like that. And I get it now. I totally get it now. Let's start that animation over, you know, for the kids. Not that I like animation so much, but let's just watch it over again so that we can all watch it and learn something. Yeah.
Okay, let's do that. And then kids, I will be right back to close us out.
Christ, he's the greatest hero posterized. Satan and defeat is sin and death.
It's Christ that I believe in.
Jesus Christ, he's the greatest hero posterized. Satan and defeat is sin and death.
It's Christ that I believe in.
There he is in the sky.
Not like Skywalker, not like the Jedi.
Not to save the good, but to save the bad.
He died on the cross.
But he rose again. Jesus Christ, he's the greatest hero posterized.
Satan and defeated,
sin and death.
It's Christ that I believe in.
Jesus Christ, he's the greatest hero posterized.
Satan and defeated,
sin and death.
It's Christ that I believe in.
He's coming back on a cloud.
Words can't hinder him from death blowing loud.
Dead in Christ shall rise first.
Then the rest of us
gonna leave this earth. Jesus Christ, he's the greatest hero posterized.
Satan and defeated,
sin and death.
It's Christ that I believe in.
Jesus Christ, he's the greatest hero posterized.
Satan and defeated,
sin and death.
It's Christ that I believe in.
I love that video because it shows us that we don't have to go about life like we're victims of Satan. Because the fact is, we are victors or conquerors of Satan through Jesus Christ. That's why Christ is the greatest hero. But since we've been talking about how Jesus became like us and got the victory over sin for us, let me explain a little bit more about how Jesus is, in fact, the greatest hero. Where did Jesus die? Jesus died on the cross. But Jesus didn't have to die. Now follow me. Jesus had some choices. Jesus, being fully God, could have saved himself. Jesus could have called on his angels to rescue him. Jesus could have lied and said he was not the Son of God, and his charges would have been dropped. And like Satan tried to get Jesus to do in the wilderness, Jesus could have bowed down to Satan and asked for his life as a reward. But Jesus would not sin against God by using his God powers or by asking the angels to come and save him from death. Jesus didn't try to get out of it by lying about who he is. Jesus didn't bow down to Satan to try to escape death. Jesus was obedient unto God, unto death, even the death of the cross. And being a human being and not sinning at all, Jesus was able to get victory over sin for all human beings. So just like Adam passed down sin and death to every human being, Jesus passed down life and victory over sin to every human being who wants it. Isn't that awesome? It truly is. Well, on that note, let's listen to one of my favorite songs that talks about the victory and rejoicing we have in Jesus. It's called Beloved. It's by Marvin Sapp and performed by Under His Strings.
Beloved, when you think of what the Lord has done, every victory that he has won, the fact that you did not make it here on your own, it ought to make you say, Beloved, when you think about the price he paid, how on Calvary your soul he saved, the fact that he suffered, bled, and died for your sin, it ought to make you say, thanks not expressed, it's no thanks at all. Every now and then you ought to testify, 'cause we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony.
Your voice is
saying,
you
tell
Lord, I like you.
Listen, beloved, listen. Say, beloved, I don't know what you've been going through, but I know that he's been good to you. Because you're still alive today, that's enough to open up your mouth and say, beloved, if he never wants to do it again, because he's always been that type of friend. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. You really ought to say,
I love that song because I love the way it celebrates Jesus, who loves us so much. Well, it's time for our giveaway and then our theme song. And I picked Blake W. Congratulations. You will get your gift this coming week. Well, next our theme song by Carissa, Janaya, Joel, Malachi, and David, and Harmony, and London.
Jesus loves me, this I know.
Each of you children who sang that song did an awesome job. Thank you so much for helping us experience the love of Jesus through the message in that song. Let's pray. Dear Father, we thank you for Jesus who became one of us, got the victory over Satan, sin, and death for us, and is coming back for us. We thank you for his love. We thank you for your love. In Jesus' name, amen.